Hey, Dwight, this season's been strange with COVID and everything. Can you just take a second to reflect on what did you learn from this season?
In terms of COVID?
No, just in terms of just the season in general. It was a weird season. Getting to game seven, just kind of looking back at the whole season, coming back from injury and everything.
That's a pretty broad question, but I guess I would say I learned a lot about a lot of things, how to stick with it. I know coming back from an injury, everybody kind of has their own experience, faced different challenges, and this year was obviously strange for a lot of reasons. And for me, kind of coupled with the rehab process and trying to figure out this kind of new climate in terms of society wrapped around this season, was difficult at times, but I did think I learned a lot about myself and a lot about who I want to be moving forward and some of the goals that I've set for myself and how to realistically approach those. So I think there's a lot of silver linings riddled throughout this experience that we've had over the last two seasons, considering the COVID-19 situation. So and the injury. So for me, it's been a good learning experience. I'm looking forward to applying some of those lessons as I move into this offseason.
Skyler?
Dwight, how much closer do you think this franchise is to competing for championships than it was when you first went through it with this group 6 years ago?
I mean, it's obviously a completely different situation, roster, league. So I don't know how to really equate the two, but I think we're definitely making strides and improvements year after year, especially these last couple of years. And I think, like I mentioned in the first question, this has been a great learning experience. I think with our ability to kind of hone in on our craft over the last year with a bunch of distractions and adversity, I think it's important for us to kind of look back and reflect on some of the ways that we were able to make things work and use those as lessons to move forward. So I think we're definitely making progress. I think that's the most important thing.
Okay, Callie.
Hey, Dwight, thanks for your time. I'm curious about your plans in the next few weeks to play for Canada in the Olympic qualifier and just what your thoughts are heading into a potential Olympic berth.
Yeah, I mean, obviously taking yesterday, today, kind of mentally recuperate, if that's the word. But then kind of going to jump back into things. Camp is on Monday, training camp is on Monday. So trying to just prepare the best I can going into that. Trying to, you know, let my body kind of heal, but at the same time prepare cardiovascularly so we can make the best run possible.
All right, a couple more here. Valencia.
Hey, Dwight, thank you for taking the time. You've been heavily involved with the community of Dallas since you got here, and even though this season looked different, you still made it a point to be involved. So I'm wondering if maybe the community had a different impact on you this year due to how different it was.
A different impact in what regard?
As far as the community of Dallas, did you see anything different from them being as though we're still in the midst of this pandemic and how we had to come together as a city?
I mean, to be honest, no. I think from day one I got here, this has been a tough city. It's been a city that's always supported us through thick and thin, and it's been a city that's been able to deal with adversity. So it was no surprise for me to see the community step up when they saw things that they needed to speak about in terms of social justice and all of those matters, and saw the community step up when COVID-19 was, you know, a big issue and communities needed help and people provided it wherever they could and supported one another. And I wasn't surprised when one of the worst winter storms came through the state and power was out and people were having to share their homes with neighbors and share food and water with neighbors. And there was no surprise to me that this city battled through all of those. And on top of all that, at the same time, we're still rooting for us and supporting us. So I wouldn't say I saw anything different, just more of the same in the best way possible. This is an amazing city with amazing people, and they've proved that year after year to me. And it's a blessing to be here and a blessing to call everyone here my neighbor.
Last one, Dorothy.
Hey, Dwight, Hi, Dwight. Thanks for your time. Over the years, what has basketball taught you about life?
What has basketball taught me about life? That's the broadest question I've ever received in my entire 7-year career, so congratulations. I need to narrow the focus for me a little bit. You're on mute.
You're muted, Dorothy. Go ahead.
Oh, okay, sorry. I mean, what has it taught you that carries over into other areas of your life? Just different skills, different...
Okay.
Just what has it taught you? Just playing basketball, being on a team, playing the sport you love, and then what you've learned there and how it's carried over to other areas of your life.
I'll pick one thing because I could write you a 12-book series about what this game has taught me. I think the one thing I would say that I learned the most from this sport, from playing basketball, is that anything is possible. I think that everybody has a different circumstance and is dealt a different hand. But in my life personally, in a lot of ways, I'm not supposed to be here. You know what I mean? And a lot of my teammates can say the same thing. We're not supposed to be on this stage. We're not supposed to be in the position that we're in, with the influence that we have. And the work we're able to do outside the court is all a blessing. So for me, that comes down to simply fighting for your dreams, regardless of how big they seem or difficult they are, or how many people tell you that you should put your energy elsewhere. If you truly believe in something, and it means enough to you, hard work, a little bit of luck, and consistency can make that a reality. And I think that's something that I think about literally every single day when I wake up, is how grateful I am to have learned some of those lessons early on and take advantage of the opportunities that I had. But at the same time, it's a blessing to have that at the front of my mind looking forward, especially after a season like this, to really truly believe that anything is possible. And as it pertains to this team particularly, the future is very bright, and I'm very excited for the potential that we have here in this city as a team and as members of this community, but also, you know, as the Mavericks in this league and what we can do moving forward. So the biggest lesson I learned is that anything is possible.
Awesome. Thanks, Dwight. All right.